Good morning, student. Today I am going to teach you computer subject, and I am taking the topic generation of computers. All of you know that computer was not invented in one day. It is the outcome of constant hard work of many scientists. Computer system basically consists of hardware and software. With the development of these components, computer system also developed day by day. This development of computer system can be classified into different generation. Now you can understand what is the meaning of generation. The terms generation, it means to change. Okay, now I am going to teach you first generation of computer. The time period of first generation of computer was 1940 to 1958. What happened in this generation? The main electronic component were used vacuum tube. Due to these electronic computer, the size of the computer increases and it take more space and consume more electricity. In this generation, assembly level language and machine level language were used. For example, Fortran, it means formula translation. ENIAC is the example of first generation computer. Now I am going to teach you in the second generation computer that what is special in second generation computer as compared to the first generation of computer. The time period was 1959 to 1964. In this generation, transistor were used the transistor were replaced in place of vacuum tube. Due to this electronic component, the size of the computer became smaller. Now it takes less space and need less energy to run it. In this generation, the processing speed increases microsecond to millisecond. In this generation, high level languages like COBOL and BASICs are used. For example, examples of first generation computer is IBM, examples are IBM 707, IBM 1400. Now we are going to discuss about the third generation of computer. The time period was 1964 to 1970. What happened in this generation? Again, in this generation, IC, it means integrated circuit, was replaced with the integrated circuit are used in place of transistor. In this generation, the size of the computer is still smaller. The processing speed increases microsecond to nanosecond. The data storage capacity improved due to the secondary storage device. Examples of this generation of computers are IBM 360, PDP, ICM. These are the example of in this generation of computer. Now we are going to discuss about the fourth generation of computer. The time period of this generation was 1971 to 1980s. What happened in this generation? Again, in this generation, integrated circuit were used in third generation, but in this generation, in fourth generation, microprocessors were used in place of IC, integrated circuit. Due to this electronic component, in this generation, computers are used for general purpose. The cost of the computers are reliable. It consumes less electricity as compared to the previous all generation. It means we can say that whatever we have got in this generation computer, it was very reliable, cheaper. In this generation, data storage capacity increases gigabyte to terabyte. Languages like SQL, C, C++, Java, all are developed in fourth generation. Now, what are the examples of this generation? Intel 4004, IBM 370, Apple. All these computers are of fourth generation. Now we are entered in the last, that is fifth generation of the computer. Now all of you think that we have seen about all these generations. It is obvious that last one is the better one. The time period was 1982 onward. In this generation, scientists are using artificial intelligence. Scientists are working to develop a different kind of software which can make the computer artificially intelligent. Now I am going to give the work according to related with this topic.